Is that my apron?
Yep.
All right.
You wanted the cupcakes, right?
I did.
So what is my cooking name today?
Cupcake Columbuka.
Beautiful.
Cute.
Mine's a little girl, like, frillier. Mine is the...
Yours is more, like, girly.
Yeah, the...
So now we're going to set up.
That's
your caramel.
This is the caramel drizzle. This is the crumb topping. This is our dough.
Now, you made that dough fresh from scratch.
From scratch.
It looks like a big sugar cookie.
It does, or like, I think it looks like a crispy. And here's our apples. Now, this one I'm going to put back in the refrigerator until we're ready to use it.
Oh, and you even got a pie book.
Yep. I've had this book for quite some time, but you can tell.
No, so you spilled some stuff on it?
This is like the butter and the flour. Here's the caramel apple pie we're going to be making. The bottom is going to be the dough, and then we put these little caramel bits on the bottom,
mm-hmm.
and then the filling, and then that bakes for a while, then we put the crumb topping on, bake it for a little while longer,
mm-hmm.
and then we put it out to cool. So let's put this back in the refrigerator until we need it. This is the crumb topping. There's butter in it. We don't want it to get too soft. Okay, so let's pre-beat the oven to 400. And now let's get these apples going, the apple sauce.
Now, do you use that juice for something else later on?
We will use it today in this pie. Let's take the liquid out of this and start slowly cooking it down.
Okay.
And while that's happening, then we'll roll out the pie dough. Here we go.
That smells good.
Thanks. Put this on a really low heat because we're not going to be able to really hover over it right now because we're going to be rolling out the pie dough.
Okay.
And then once we've got the pie dough together, then we can bump up the heat on that.
Now, what kind of apples did you get? Were they Granny Smiths? Or?
2 Granny Smith and 5 Golden Delicious.
Oh, you got some great apples in there.
Oh, see, this is already getting...
Is it getting a little too soft?
It's getting a little too soft. We're going to work with it, but...
Okay.
It's... I don't like when it's soft.
Like baker professional, yeah.
This is way too soft. But we're just going to... We're going with it. We have to.
Okay.
And this is starting... I'm getting kind of...
Are you getting
anxious?
Okay. Yep.
Because of what's going on in front of me, see how it's not, and it's never perfect, but this crevice or this crack is
right.
Getting a little too deep. This is okay, but this is freaking me out a little bit.
Okay. It looks beautiful.
Thank you. And we're working with a deep dish, so we need to roll it out so it's a
so it can drapes over the side.
So we can get it so it's up to this lip.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Deep breath. Okay.
It's beautiful. Look at that. It's a great job.
Thanks. And what we'll finish doing here is shaping it,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, doing the fancy edge. And then we put it in the freezer.
Oh,
and
the freezer.
And that'll firm up while we're taking care of the other ingredients. And
okay.
With this particular pie, you put the caramel bits in at the bottom,
uh-huh.
and then put it in the freezer. So now we're just kind of working the edge of the dough to create... You know, a border.
So you're not letting the dough lay over the lip of the dish. You're pinching it down to make it even with the edge of the...
Yes.
Okay.
Because I don't want the sticking. I want it laying on top of that edge,
uh-huh.
but I don't want it to stick to the edge. It's coming together.
Yeah, it is.
The caramel, and I've quartered the caramel. I could have just thrown the caramel in there.
No, you want them even.
And then done this, but I like every bite to be the same. I like consistency. in the freezer she goes.
In the freezer you go. And now we know your secrets, so hopefully, you know.
I don't have any secrets in the kitchen.
You don't?
I really don't. Maybe I should.
Do I smell cinnamon?
Yep, cinnamon, sugar.
Sugar.
Granulated sugar, brown sugar, cinnamon, vanilla, a tablespoon of lemon juice. I just like to get all the, everything mixed up. While we're waiting for this, we could, we need a half a cup of chopped pecans for the top.
Have you ever caught yourself like eating most of the ingredients before you put them like in a pie pan? Like you'd eat half a bag of pecans, maybe a quarter stick of butter, and you know, most of the apples?
No, that's a good question. Huh? But no, I haven't really done it.
Really? And it looks like it's thickening too.
It is a little bit already.
It's almost like a gravy, like an apple gravy.
Yeah. I busted a hole in there, but who cares? Thanks,
How's
Rich.
This going?
Good, we're almost there.
Can you go too long or too hot or whatever?
Yep. Yeah, we could scald it.
Could you?
Mm-hmm. To keep a watchful eye on it.
Feel too liquidy still to you, or is it starting to thicken up to your satisfaction?
See, now I'm not really going on feeling. I'm going
on visuals.
See how it's kind of starting to stick to the side a little bit.
Okay.
And you can see it almost looks gelatinous.
Oh, okay. So how gelatinous-y do you get it to where it's like perfect? Because I wouldn't know where to stop here.
I just go, we're almost there in my opinion.
Are you going to put the reduced juice in with the apples now? And then you mix everything up?
Yep.
Oh my God, look how thick and wonderful that is.
All right.
Oh, that's beautiful. Everything got all covered.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see how glistening the apples are.
We're ready to take the pie.
Freezer
out of the morgue. Put this in the pie shell, and we're going to bake it for 30 minutes.
Oh, really? That's it?
Well, and then we take it out and put the crumb top in.
Oh, okay.
That's a lot of apples. That's why we need the deep dish. Work the apples in so there's no big gaps.
Yeah.
And I want to get all this in. And it looks like we missed quite a bit of juice. I'm afraid it won't thicken up.
If I went to the store tonight and bought me 4 apples and cut them in slices like you did and then put them in a bowl in the refrigerator, the next morning I would wake up and I'd have all this juice that came leaked out.
Yeah.
Really? Okay. I think that's
interesting. Maybe not as, like, I don't know. You would have liquid, but I don't know if you would have as much as we did because we added lemon juice.
There it is.
There we go.
Wow.
And that was a love pat. That last one, that was a love pat.
Was that a love pat?
That was a love
pat. The pie is ready to get cooked. It looks beautiful in there.
And nighty-night.
Beautiful. And then you time it for 30 minutes, is that right?
30 minutes.
Okay, at 400.
At 400.
Okay. We're going to have to do a hand smack on that one.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Yo, that was a good one.
All right, Rich. Are you ready?
I am ready.
All right, you're going to roll this out.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're going to dust the counter.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I think you're getting close. Because we don't, how's it feel?
Do you think
that's what I do, yep.
Okay. So I should probably bring this closer to me. Please don't think it's stick. All right, so you just pull it over?
Mm-hmm. Look at that!
All right, now we're gonna bring this here.
How you feeling, Rich? I think you're in the zone. Like lovely.
Not as good as what you do.
This is your first time though. Bobby, come and take a look at Rich's first pie dough crust. And he rolled it out. He did everything on his own.
All right, little pie crust. There you go. These crumbles now will melt because there's sugar in them.
Mm-hmm, okay. Butter and sugar.
Do you eat any of these crumbly toppings before you decide?
I didn't. Do you want to try one? Mm-hmm. I've never tried it. It should be yummy though. I like see how the crust is already, that in my opinion, that's already done. The edge of the crust, I don't want that any darker. So I'm going to put this on there. But it's not quite big enough, which bothers me, but it's the biggest one I have.
All right, don't burn yourself.
Okay.
Now this goes in for another...
I think it said 30 to 35, but our oven...
varies.
Hot.
Well, now we're going to go with this Libby's recipe. Mm-hmm. So according to my bad eyesight, it looks like 3/4 cup of sugar. Make sure this isn't salt. Could you imagine if I got the two mixed up? So now we have 3/4 cup of sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Now what we need to do is a half, is that a half? Half a cup of salt? Because I can't see. Or quarter.
Okay, half teaspoon.
Wow, okay. Why didn't I wear my glasses today?
I don't know. I'm sorry, I don't mean to be a control freak, but I would not measure salt over that because in case it dumps out, then we have to start over.
Okay.
Sorry, I didn't.
No. And of course, we want to keep it level, just
mm-hmm.
like that.
Yep.
So here's one. Mmm, love ground herb cinnamon.
Let's see what we've got next.
Looks like a half a teaspoon of ground ginger. So
that's it.
Is that half?
Half a teaspoon.
So half a teaspoon.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to write to Libby and we're going to tell them to get the fonts much bigger. All right, so ground ginger, and we're going to use 1/2 teaspoon.
Lovely.
All right, and then we need 1/4 teaspoon of ground cloves. Here we go. Now we got our dry ingredients because now the next item on is 2 large eggs, which
mm-hmm.
we do not want to do at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and mix our dry ingredients together. It looks like sand.
Yeah, it does. You took the words right out of my mouth.
We're going to put the 2 large brown,
mm-hmm.
free-range eggs.
Very important. Free-range.
Free-range.
Happy
that
chickens.
That means that the chickens just run all
yep.
over the place. Do 2. And those shells in there,
mm-hmm.
please. So then we're just going to go just like that, and that
mm-hmm.
should be
lovely.
Right there, what
yep.
we need. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and pour all of those in right here. Now we're going to add our pumpkin, which is what, 14.5 ounces? No, 15 ounces.
I think the important part is mixing the dry ingredients first, like we did.
Okay.
And then
adding the
evaporated milk last. Slowly, because otherwise it's... Ooh.
That beautiful color.
Yep, Thanksgiving.
So we're going to just stick it in there. We'll get up and... now help me out here because I cannot see how
mm-hmm.
much evaporated milk.
Well, I would mix that...
First. Okay.
And then it's the entire can.
Oh, it is?
And we have to...
Do we have to do one
shake
of those
well.
Oh, okay, we do have to shake it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I will do that. So first, we're going to go ahead and get our
mm-hmm.
pumpkin mixed up here. I did not shake well, but that's okay because it's going to get stirred in
mm-hmm.
here. It scares me that it's so liquid.
Yep.
But you say that it's supposed to
yep.
do this
for It us. Is scary, though.
So we got this beautiful
mm-hmm.
pumpkin color,
mm-hmm.
and then when it bakes, it should brown, and it's the color should be more brown.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there we go.
It's magic time.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Are you excited?
I am.
Look at that.
Oh, I should turn the timer off.
How do you do that? Just hit it?
Yep. And what we need to do, the top definitely looks done.
Uh-huh.
We have to check in
Make
to
sure
see
the...
if there's any bubbling around the edges.
Perfect. Not one crumb came out of
Woo!
That. And look at that crust. How beautiful that is.
I think we should pull it.
Okay. Well, you're the baker.
Let's do it.
Does it feel like it weighs 10 pounds?
Yeah, it's heavy. I don't know if it's 10 pounds. Maybe we're exaggerating a little bit, but it is heavy.
Just let it cool till whenever, then.
Well,
usually it takes about an hour.
Quite a bit, and then we still want it a little warm when we add that caramel drizzle.
And pull out our interestingly done pie
Look
crust.
At that.
What I have to do is just pour this mixture in
mm-hmm.
there. Does that look like a familiar color?
Yep.
And texture?
It's what it always looks like.
Okay. Well, I think we've done 15 minutes, haven't we?
Yeah, at 425? I think we're good. That in the oven for 15 minutes at 425.
Oh, you're right.
And then we reduce it to whatever. What did you say? 370?
Looks like 350 to me.
We're going to slip this in here.
Oh,
and let's see how pumpkin pie is doing.
Yeah, let's
here.
Take a peek.
Let's take
Ready?
A peek, yep. Well,
looking good.
We put on the crust cover here earlier, so that way it wouldn't overly brown.
Mm-hmm.
And we have about 6 minutes left before the pie comes out. You will add the last ingredient to the apple pie.
I've already
You've done your
measured
preparation.
Out the caramel and the butter.
And butter.
Okay. And then I think we need to add some water. Only a tablespoon.
Okay. So a splash, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? I'm not even going to measure it.
Be brave.
Okay, all right.
This is what you have to do.
All right.
You know what a splash looks like.
I'm going to do this.
Now that we got 6 cups of water in here.
Yeah. And there's the knife for the pumpkin pie.
Oh, we might be there.
Let's go 5 minutes. What do you think, chef?
Five sounds good.
All right, here we go.
So we're looking at caramel, butter, and a splash of water. Mm-hmm. Things are quickly melting. So,
are they?
Mm-hmm. The butter is.
Now what are you doing there, Rich?
Well, what I'm going to do now is make sure that when I stick the knife in the middle of the pie that it comes out clean, and then we know we don't need to bake it any longer and that it's done. And I'm still thinking the middle's too is not done yet.
Mm-mm. A little bit longer.
Your double boiling system is working quite well.
Thanks.
Melted up fast yes. and nice, didn't it?
Yep, we're almost there. Here we go. I think we're ready. Mm-hmm. All right, let's go grab
so we need
the pie.
Okay, I'll grab the pie. Because I think we are about ready to let the pumpkin pie
launch.
Yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that drizzling. You're a drizzling queen. When you get all of these desserts, you're one lucky guy there, man.
We're there! I would pull it. That's done.
You think so?
Yeah,
I think so,
done.
Too.
That's a clean knife.
That's Rich's first pie, though.
Been knifed to death. It looks like I tried to kill it. Multiple stab wounds. Oh!
That's awesome, Rich.
We did it.
We
Cupcake
did it.
And
yep,
donuts.
And donuts.
Yes, yes.
Cupcake Columbo.
And Donut Denise.
Yep.
Now we're going to do one slap.
Oh.
All right, one more.
All right.